Today, I would like to speak about the origin and destiny of intelligence in our universe. The second law of thermodynamics says that the total amount of disorder, or entropy, always increases over time. However, there is a loophole allowing a small system to decrease its disorder as long as it increases the disorder of its surroundings by an even greater amount. Our initially barren universe has evolved remarkably complex entities doing just this, as well as reproducing. We call these entities life. Information is at the heart of life. DNA passes the blueprints of life between generations. At some point during our 13.8 billion years of cosmic history, something beautiful happened. This information processing got so intelligent that life forms became conscious. I've given you a brief history of intelligence. What's next? Some think that humanity today is the pinnacle of evolution, and that this is as good as it gets. I disagree. Up to now, computers have obeyed Moore's law, which says that computers double their speed and memory capacity every 2 years. The result is that computers are likely to overtake humans in intelligence at some point in the next 100 years. Recent landmarks such as self-driving cars, a computer winning at Jeopardy, and the digital personal assistants, Siri, Google Now, and Cortana, are merely symptoms of an IT arms race. Everything that civilization has to offer is a product of human intelligence. We cannot predict what we might achieve when this intelligence is amplified by the tools AI may provide. But the eradication of war, disease, and poverty would be high on anyone's list. In short, the advent of super-intelligent AI would be either the best or the worst thing ever to happen to humanity, so we should plan ahead. Little serious research has been devoted to these issues outside a few small, non-profit institutes. Fortunately, this is now changing. Technology pioneers Elon Musk, Bill Gates, and Steve Wozniak have echoed my concerns, and a healthy culture of risk assessment and awareness of societal implications is beginning to take root in the AI community. Many of the world's leading AI researchers recently signed an open letter calling for the goal of AI to be redefined from simply creating raw undirected intelligence to creating intelligence directed at benefiting humanity. The Future of Life Institute, where I serve on the Scientific Advisory Board, has just launched a global research program aimed at keeping AI beneficial. When we invented fire, we messed up repeatedly, then invented a fire extinguisher. With more powerful technologies such as nuclear weapons, synthetic biology, and strong artificial intelligence, we should instead plan ahead and aim to get things right the first time, because it may be the only chance we will get. I'm an optimist, and don't believe in boundaries, neither for what we can do in our personal lives, nor for what life and intelligence can accomplish in our universe. This means that the brief history of intelligence that I have told you about is not the end of the story, but just the beginning of what I hope will be billions of years of life flourishing in the cosmos. Our future is a race between the growing power of our technology and the wisdom with which we use it. Let's make sure that wisdom wins. Thank you for listening.